Hi, I'm Maureen Mader, and this is Video Voters Guide, a service of the League of Women Voters, a 102-year-old nonpartisan organization that believes democracy depends on informed and active participation. For more election information, be sure to visit our online site, vote411.org, before you mark your ballot. Today we have Sherry Hall running for Clackamas County Clerk. Welcome, Sherry.
Thank you for inviting me.
Great. Well, we have about 8 to 10 minutes to spend with you, and we're going to ask you some questions. And I'll let you do an opening statement. We'll at the end, we'll do about a minute of a closing statement, and that'll be it. So let's get started. Tell us about your experience and why you have decided to run for re-election for this office.
Okay, my experience is 20 years as Clackamas County Clerk. I know the department very well. In fact, I had worked in the recording office when I first went to work for the county several years ago. The clerk administers elections, recording, records management, which means we house all of the records in the county, including the state court records, and then Board of Property Tax Appeals, which means if you get your tax statement on your property, you think it's out of whack, you can appeal that amount through our office. Elections, of course, is the most focused piece of the job. I love all of it. I love the job because we are doing the fun things for people in life when they get married, when they buy a house or sell a house, and then the privilege that we have of voting. And I don't like the politics around elections, which seems to get heavier every year, but we maintain the process of elections and we don't allow politics in the office. And I decided to run again, actually at the encouragement of some in my county and some in my clerk's association in the state. There was one candidate who filed, and it's kind of like you need to give the voters a choice. And so I am back, and I hope to win this again.
Okay, great. How do you plan to rebuild trust and credibility with voters in the aftermath of the May primary?
Okay, the May primary was not something I did. It was done by the external printer that we have used for 10 years. To print our ballots. And to rebuild trust, I think also goes along with just all of the conspiracy thoughts that are out there because of what happened in 2020. It's actually been going on for 2 years or more. One of the things we do is allow observers into any area of our office. And I'm very thankful that the chair of the Clackamas Republicans and one of the executive committee members of the Clackamas Democrats come into our office almost every day while observers are in the office, and they're able to answer many questions. There is so much detail and legal application in elections. We don't listen to opinions. We go strictly to the law. And we allow no political conversations or political clothing to be worn in our office or in the observation area. And as a matter of building trust, it's just going to be one day after the other of answering questions, allowing them to see what we do, answering all of their questions, and hopefully that will build. In the 2020 election, where many states switched to vote by mail close to election day, there's just been so many stories and so many newscasts on a lot of those. And that is not always what happens in Oregon. We've done vote by mail for 20 years. All of the laws are in place. And it's a very transparent system. And all clerks in Oregon, as far as I know, keep it that way. So all we can do is, you know, keep answering their questions when they want to have conversations or tell us why they don't trust something. We will explain how it actually happens.
Okay, what do you see as this office's major goals for the coming term? and what resources are needed to meet them?
Okay, well, as I said, the clerk is over, we administer records management, recording, other things besides elections. And in the records management department is our biggest goal, because we need to explore the explore for purchase types of Department of Defense 50-15 sensitive software suited for archiving permanent electronic records. We do fine with paper records, but many things are now electronic. So that would be a new set of software. And we will work with our IT department, and also in the budgeting process. I hope we have our answers by the time we do budget, so that we can, you know, quote what it might cost. And that is the major goal for my office for next year. Next year is an off election year, so we won't have a primary or a general. We will have the special districts election in May, like we do every other odd numbered year. And the redistricting has been completed, and that should be, you know, perfect and ready to go, so everyone gets the right ballot. This whole department is a matter of just keeping on top of everything every day, and keeping it running smoothly, and keeping trained, well-trained staff.
Okay. County clerks are being inundated with records requests and challenges to voter eligibility. What will you do, or what are you doing, to deal with this added workload?
Well, that's been a conversation among us. The County Clerks Association have our weekly call every Monday. And then we also have a state wide call with the state elections department. So all of their crew and all of the clerk election crew are on the phone together. And these things get discussed. The first priority for everyone at this point has been this November election, to build it correctly and get the voters pamphlet done correctly. And we have deadlines, and so that has to be done first. But we will, you know, there's different ways that public records requests are being addressed. And there's something rather new. We have gotten many letters, many counties have gotten many letters from people who start out saying, I am an aggrieved citizen, and I want you to keep all of the election records from 2019 forward. And my county council also sent me that email, and I immediately responded and said, we have a two-year retention schedule, and so everything up through May of 2020 has been destroyed, which is what the retention schedule says. But now that we have all of these other letters from citizens stating that what I just said, we will be keeping them longer until that piece is settled. And county councils are involved in that. We actually did a call also statewide with county councils and county clerk and election directors. So there's a lot of new stuff coming our way, and we rely on the attorneys to direct us, and to the Secretary of State. She is the chief elections officer for the state, so they all also give us direction for how to handle them. But we just have an exorbitant amount of those kind of letters. And so the November election is number one, and those will all be addressed at some point.
Okay. Our time goes so quickly in these interviews, so we're at our closing. So I'd like to give you a minute to tell the voters why they should vote for you.
Well, again, I do have 20 years experience. I know all aspects of the clerk's office, not just elections. And there's lots of, you know, extra work coming our way, along with a lot of criticism and everything else. And I think I handle it very well. I resource the proper source for that, which is the attorney and the Secretary of State. And I know how to calmly conduct my work and stay focused in what my work is and get it done on time. And with the May election, we had a deadline of June 13th to certify the election, which we did. Then every county gets hand counts, because we do in every primary and general election. And we met that deadline on time. And then Clackamas County got a huge hand count, 255 batches, which was used as an audit of our duplication of the ballots. And that was completed completely on time. There was nothing that missed the deadline. And I can do that. And I think I'm the one for the job.
Okay. Well, Sherry, thank you so much for talking with us today. And voters, don't forget to visit vote411.org for complete candidate and ballot measure information.